If you say that you are mine, I'll be here till the end of the line. So you've got to let me know, should I stay or should I go? It's always tease, tease, tease. You're happy when I'm on my knees. One day it's fine, the next it's black. So if you want me off your back, well come on and let me know. Should I stay or should I go? Should I stay or should I go now? Should I stay or should I go now? If I go, there will be trouble. And if I stay, it will be double. So come on and let me know. This indecision's bugging me.
Indecision may molest
me. If you don't want me, set me. Exactly whom I'm supposed to be. Don't you know which clothes even fit me?
They got me, asshole.
Come on and let me know. Should I stay or should I go?
Oh shit! Get the briefcase, Lippe! The window, the window!
Beautiful thing.
Yep.
Hit. By who?
They stole what?
Got to say, that was badass.
Come on! We are rich! Come on!
Don't blow your loads yet. Let's see what we have. Lips.
That's the most beautiful thing I've ever seen.
So, what happens now?
Well, gentlemen, we sell it. It's unfortunate we lost Pete. But on the bright side, everybody's cut just went through the roof. For me, well, who knows? Blanchett, Turner, whatever you want. Aitken, maybe a Ferrari or two. Yeah. And Vaughn. Actually, yeah, Vaughn, what do you want?
Cornwall Police Department, nobody move!
What the shit?
Vaughn, what the hell? You're a fucking cop?
Hands in the air, motherfuckers, you're under arrest! Don't move, Aitken! Don't move a muscle! Lippe, the briefcase down. Aitken, stop! The briefcase down!
You son of a...
Put the briefcase down!
Holy shit!
What the fuck just happened?
That bastard. He played us.
He beat me to it.
Aitken, what the fuck?
Shut up, Blanchett. Lips, give me the briefcase.
Motherfucker!
Stay put, Turner. I don't want to kill you. Lips, the briefcase. Good. And now you portray steel frames for the next 3 minutes. Ciao.
What do we do now?
Okay, listen up. You all know what happened. I got stabbed in the back by people I trusted. One of you. Six of you, to be exact. I'm proud that you got one of them, but five of them are still out there. And they got something that belongs to me. I need you to find them. I need you to find them now. I want you to bring their heads to me, preferably cut open, so I can piece their skulls full! But most importantly, bring me what they stole. Bring it back. Take everything you need. Take all the resources. Ask and you shall receive. Bring them to me. And bring me back what they stole.
What are you still waiting for? Go! Go, go!
expected, blizzard has left the southern parts of otherwise sunny Converse County covered in snow. Elsewhere in the region, the heat wave continues, so people, remember your fur hats and sunscreen today.
One was a cop, Aitken a trader. I think I broke my goddamn nose. But he's got the briefcase. God damn it, what a mess.
I'm gonna get that piece of shit.
Yeah, man. That's the fucking spirit.
Yeah, let's do it.
You two won't do anything.
What?
You two don't see the big picture. You do realize we just robbed Maxwell Richmond, the biggest mobster in town. His men are going to be all over us.
Shit. But at least Richmond wouldn't want the cops involved, so the PD won't come after us.
I wouldn't count on that either. I'm sure Richmond's banker's getting off the phone with the police chief right about now. After making sure the PD knows how generous of a man he is. Richmond's men have got free hands, and the coppers got our descriptions marked on the backs of theirs.
Fucking hell. What do we do then?
To be fair, I got no idea. I gotta make a few phone calls.
I'd love to thank Aitken personally for this whole situation. At least he killed Vaughn. If Vaughn was alive and after us, this would be twice as worse. Did you see him back at the warehouse? That guy's the devil himself.
Converse Police Department, Captain Tomlinson.
Marcus, it's Samuel Vaughn.
Sam? Samuel? What in the gloom? Fuck! 18 months, Vaughn!
I know.
be undercover in Maxwell Richmond's league for 18 months. Nobody in the police department has heard from you since. No reports, no nothing.
Some say you turned codes for real.
It's been an uphill battle. Fuck.
Shit, Simon, you alright? It's a huge rumble in my station right now. Word is, something went down in Richmond's warehouse in Cromwell.
Word is right. Shit!
What the hell happened?
Listen, Marcus. You're the only one I can trust right now. You know your own station is crooked as fuck. All in Richmond's pocket.
Yeah. I just overheard Richmond's put out a bounty. And some of my officers are looking to collect. But on who? What the hell happened?
It's a story longer than a year of famine. I'm not gonna tell you over the phone. Look, I need you to pick me up.
Yeah, we ran over.
Hey man!
Ryan Aitken! Oh. What the hell, man? Get in!
Here you go!
Okay. Okay, man, what brings you here?
No time for tea, chat, Trent. I've got some merchandise you could find at distributor.
Shit, man, I don't sound like sauce pipes no more. I'm big time now. Only coke and meth.
This is much better.
Show me!
Talking about it right now. No, no. Who's got it? I don't know exactly, but I'm going to find out, okay? Don't worry. I'll hold my end of the deal. As long as you hold yours, okay? Alright. Thank you.
What deal?
You misheard. Don't worry about it.
No, you said you'd hold your end of the deal. To who? Who are you talking to?
It's none of your business, guys. I'll handle it.
What's that now?
Yeah. First you think you know better than we do, and now you talk to us like this. Who do you think you are, big friends?
It's a complicated business. And you guys volunteered for this job. It was all to get messy. And now the downfall is going to get even messier. I'll handle it.
We're all in this together. We need to know what's up.
Come on now. We deserve to know.
All right, just don't freak out, okay? I had a buyer for the Iridescent.
You what?
I said don't freak out.
You had a buyer behind our backs?
You've got to be kidding me.
Hey, listen. I'm the one with the connections, okay? I've sold ice to Alaskans a million apiece. I've sold a fresco to Vatican as a Michelangelo. I've sold llama shirts to alpaca shepherds, alpaca shirts to llama shepherds.
Really?
You've done all those things?
The point is, I've got connections, okay? And this buyer is willing to give me a sum, an unimaginable sum, for the Iridescent. an unimaginable sum that I'd obviously share with you two.
I'm starting to think this isn't worth it. Not even worth $100,000.
Those sums swung throughout while setting this up were all bullshit. We're talking about 300 million.
What?
300 million, guys. 100 a man. Think about that.
That's... But you didn't tell us. How can we trust you?
But, Todd, that's 300 million. I think we can forgive him.
Come on now, Alex. How can we trust this guy? He went behind our backs to some billionaire and offered them something he didn't even have yet. And now we have to follow his crazy plans, just to get backstabbed again.
Let's at least talk about this.
You want to risk everything getting the briefcase back. And even if you pull it off, this guy just caps us and takes the money for himself.
You need to give him a chance, man.
Out.
Great.
What do we do now?
Thanks. You got the files you asked for.
Okay, tell me the whole story now.
A little under 2 years ago, the treasury was robbed by the Maxwell Richmond League. They stole something invaluable. Check the file on top.
What the hell is this?
They call it the Iridescent. It's simply the greatest piece to ever exist. Nobody can put a price on it, but in an auction, it could go for $100 million. More in the black market.
Holy fuck.
Yeah. Richmond is rich enough already, but he's got a thing for these things. He just wanted to look at it and jerk off or something. Put it in a briefcase and locked it into his warehouse. He spends every Saturday just sitting next to it. Spent.
So, what the hell happened? What's your part in this?
The treasury, of course, wanted it back. So they called my precinct. Someone needed to go undercover and steal the Iridescent back. I have experience with those kind of assignments, so I volunteered. I spent months gaining Richmond's trust while getting to know his men a little better. I realized I couldn't pull off the heist on my own, so I recruited the most promising ones to help me. Loyalty to Richmond wasn't an issue. I just drew a number and they were all in. The sums I drew out, they were sold that second. The rest, I told you on the way.
So, one of these men has the Iridescent. Could you introduce us?
Peter McAllister. You can swipe him off. He's dead. Richmond's men shot him at the warehouse.
All right. Who's this?
Ryan Aiken. That's the son of a bitch who shot me and stole my car. Real asshole, too. If you've seen a street race, you've seen him win one.
And this guy?
Todd Blanchett, a young fella, up and coming. But he's made his living pickpocketing so far. Usually works with Alex Turner, the next guy on the pile. They're pretty tight, childhood friends. Turner's the lockpicking master. He got us through the security systems at Richmond's warehouse, too.
Wow, I know this guy.
Yeah, Philip Lippe. They call him Lips. Classic conman. He thinks robbery is as much of an art form as sculpting and painting. You know, They say he stole the Mona Lisa once and replaced it with his own crayon copy. It took 3 weeks until Lovre noticed, and the real one hasn't been found.
Christ. And they were all Richmond's men?
Yeah. One way or another, they had all ended up on his payroll. I presume Richmond is after these guys and me. I'm pretty sure they've split up by now. One of them has the briefcase and is either trying to hide it or sell it.
But who?
I've got no fucking clue.
So, you know anyone who would want one of these?
You could be a lot, dog. I recently heard someone's got their eye on this thing.
Good. Make the call. It's lukewarm, so I ain't got a lot of time. I'll catch you.
You got it, Ryan.
What's up, Derek?
What's up?
Hey! Yeah, it's me, Trent. I understand you're a busy man, okay? Yeah, but you gotta listen to me, okay? I got something amazing to offer to you, sir.
You got what?
Got my man on the line! He's gonna send the money man to get your merchandise!
What now?
Yeah, man, you can count on Trent.
Yes! Ugh! Afro! Just had an interesting phone call with that piece of shit gangbanger Trent we've been working with from time to time. And he's trying to sell me the Iridescent. Me! Can you believe that? You go get back what's mine.
You have got to be kidding me.
Why? Why did you have to turn him down like that?
He had talked to a buyer behind our backs. If he was planning to split the money with us, why didn't he tell us?
We had a heist to plan. What comes after, comes after.
What comes after, comes after? What the shit? Heist this big, you plan everything beforehand.
Well, we probably should have. Because now it's just the two of us and the police and the biggest mobster in town are all after us. We've got to take him out before he takes us out.
What we've got to do is hide and escape the country fast.
What we got to do is find some food. I'm starving.
Right. Let's take this one step at a time. What do we need right now?
Food. Shelter.
We'll be right back.
now. Money man, see it.
Here, we have Aitken, my dear friend who just brought in the piece.
Of multiple gunshots fired at 38 Warden Place. Two suspects seen fleeing the scene, one in black suit with a briefcase, the other in red shirt and light-colored jeans. Possibly armed and dangerous.
Briefcase? And that last one sounded like Ryan Aiken.
And Warden Place? That's gangbanger territory. That drink guy's worked with Richmond before.
Let's go.
All right. What I say we do is hit up that guy Nicholson. get us some fake passports and move to Iria or Stania or something.
Stania? You've got to be kidding me. Stania! And run in this situation. What do we do then? Run, run, and run for the rest of our lives.
You're crazy if you think we can take out Richmond by ourselves. And even if we somehow manage to pull that off, we still have the police on our ass.
Not necessarily. Like Leif said, they're all on Richmond's payroll. If he goes, they've got no obligations.
Like Leif said, how can you believe anything that guy said? That guy's a freaking con man.
Picking pockets is a more trustworthy profession. I'm not going to be spending my whole life looking over my shoulder. You can sit here and wait until this all comes back to bite you. But I'm going after Maxwell Richmond. Adios.
Come on. Please. Alex, we've known for ages. Money can't come between us.
This isn't about money, Todd. This isn't about trusting a con man's word. This isn't about Richmond. This is about you and me and you not trusting me. We were in over our heads with this one, but if we want to keep ourselves alive, this is how we do it. By killing Richmond.
That's my point. We're in over our heads. We can't do it. We can't kill Richmond.
And there's no way. Trust me.
Come on, Alex, please. Alex, come on, Alex, you can't go. They're going to kill you.
Oh, okay. Yeah. We're right there. Yeah.
What was that about?
We've got to turn around. Apparently, one of Richmond's men ran over somewhere in the suburb, and if the description's anything to go by, Philip Lipe's days better.
Oh, shit!
Out the window and put your hands in the air. This just might be your masterpiece.
That's Ambrose, Maxwell Richmond's right-hand man.
Let's try to put this together. Aiken shoots me, steals the iridescent from Lippe and the others, and I don't know, uses Trent the gangbanger to convey it.
Then Trent gets in touch with Richmond, tries to sell it to him. Richmond sends his number one hitman to get the briefcase. It's gotta be in the car.
Leave no stone unturned. Ambrose already have dropped it off back to Richmond.
Mr. Richmond, an urgent delivery from Mr. Ambrose.
Show your face after stabbing me in the back.
I'd say I've done a lot more than that.
I presume you're here for the iridescent?
No, I'm here for you. But on a second thought, yeah, give me the briefcase.
I'm afraid I can't do that. My soul belongs to the iridescent. If it wasn't inanimate, we'd be helping to bully with rings on our fingers. We'd make pretty babies.
You're a crazy man, right?
No. I'm a man in love.
Whatever. Give me the briefcase or this guy dies of sudden lead poisoning.
Did you hear a fucking word I said? I don't care about any of these guys. I only care about the iridescent. It is my everything.
Fucking exactly. Because of you, I lost my best friend, who was everything to me. Now, I'm gonna take your everything.
You will try.
Doctor, I need something for the pain.
What has happened, Miss Silly Pain?
Something for the pain, Doc.
Whoa. My other patients take already everything I have.
Everything?
Yes, everything.
What other patient?
Oh, alright, let's get you seated, okay? I'll go see if I have something for you.
Lips? Aitken? Aitken!
Oh, Billy!
Doc, get away from me!
Billy!
Just get away, Doc! Come on now! My bare hands!
Why can't I feel my leg?
I'm sorry, Mr. Aitken. I can't save it. Your leg has gone into gangrene. We're going to have to amputate it.
Amputate?
Would you please let go of my patient? He needs to rest for the operation.
No, I'm gonna get you, bitch. Go off me, you freak.
Area is surrounded. Come out of the cabin with the photons in the air and surrender. It's over.
Yes, Lipe didn't lie about everything.
Porch, get your hand in the air.
I want to say something. never take me alive!
Jesus Christ.
What the hell happened here?
Wait a minute. That's Alex Turner.
Oh my God. Is that what I think it is?
It really is. You secure it, take it to the car. I'll check inside.
Yeah.
Inside.
Maxwell Richmond?
Dead. The Iridescent?
Safe and sound. I'd say that's case closed.
There are reports of a ginger chasing a crawling man near the forested area in Kenwood. Shots fired.
That's got to have something to do with this.
Yeah, let's go.
I don't know where to look anymore.
Go, Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Johnny be good. He used to carry his guitar and a gun in his back. Go sit beneath the tree by the railroad track. Old engineer with him sitting in the shade. Strumming with the rhythm that the drivers made. People passing by, they would stop and say, oh my, but that little country boy could play. Go, 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 Johnny, go, 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 Johnny, go, go.
You just couldn't let everyone have a share, no?
You just can't let things go.
The whole thing was doomed from the get-go, Lips. Remember, Samuel Ward was a cop, and you capped him. We could have gotten away with the whole thing.
Maybe, if I didn't sign up for this madness in the first place, I'd still have two working legs.
Don't get me wrong, Aitken. This is as personal as it gets.
Lippy! Drop the gun and stay still. It's over. Don't even think about running!
Get Aitken.
Yeah!
There's a bit of a situation. Yes, ma'am, I'll deliver it to you as promised.
Freeze, Aiken!
Can't you guys just give me a freaking break already?
Thank you. So tough guy after all, huh?
What the hell?
Motherfucker. So listen!
Lippe, he's got the briefcase.
Shot!
Nah, it's just a flesh wound. You need to go after him.
You sure?
Yeah, I'll call back up. Someone pick me up.
Alright, just press it. I got Lippe's phone. The last number he called has got an address to it. It's gotta be his buyer.
Finish this, Sam. Go!
Thank you.
Hey man, who's the occupant of this place?
Madame Caroline Delacroix, monsieur.
Jewel princess. That's convenient. I need to see her right away.
I'm afraid that can't be done, monsieur.
That was no request, monsieur CPD. You're under arrest! Put down the silverware! Where's Philip Lippe?
Quite an entrance, I must say. Perhaps now we can get down to business, Mr. Lippe.
Finally.
I must say, at times I had difficulty believing in the efficiency of this scheme of yours, but here we are.
Well, I gotta admit, it was tricky at times. But don't blame the game. Blame the player, who doesn't know how to play.
Well, you definitely do. Excellent work, Mr. Lippe.
And, my money?
Oh, yes. For this sort of work, you must be rewarded graciously. Seeing the fruit of your work in person, I must give you something we didn't even discuss. You imbecile! Do you think I'm stupid, or are you? Didn't you even check this before you brought it to me?
Madame Delacroix, it's a phone call for you.
Oui? I'm listening.
Thank you.
money's been wired. Pleasure to do business with you.
Likewise.
Isn't it interesting, Mr. Tomlinson, how everyone who touches the iridescent ends up dead? Or in pieces?
You tell me.
Thank you.
oceans apart, day after day, and I slowly go insane. I hear your voice on the line, but it doesn't stop the pain. If I see you next to never, then how can we see?
This romance.